afternoon. Our job is to provide objective information about the software under test. We do whatever it takes to achieve sufficient test coverage, and to achieve that, we develop massive test libraries. Defects can slip through testing gaps. Identifying and closing such gaps remains our utmost priority. We deal with complex distributed platform processing an abundance of inward, outward, and internal messages. Process mining, though, is a family of business analysis techniques, and they are based on the event logs, and we do have lots of events in our systems. Well, in some systems, they are present in logs, and for example, for low latency platforms, they can be extracted as a wire capture. And let's consider the simplest example of an order lifecycle, order status lifecycle. So we've gathered the transactional data from a system under test and built a graphical representation of an order transitions. So in general, the order lifecycle consists of a few parts. First, the participant establishes the connection, then sends orders. And the system validates the request. And based on this, the order will be placed or not into the order book for further activities. And the system will assign our status tag to this request at every step of this cycle. And each order status change is communicated to the participant via the execution report message. And the table on the right shows some of the examples of the order statuses in the system. So, depending on the order type, trading session, instrument status, the participant receives different values of order status and exact types in the execution report messages. And even for this simple test case, there are many, many potential execution scenarios. And the graph allows us to view and assess the test coverage in a human readable format. In this particular case, one can see that the extracted transactional data actually lacks suspended and partially filled statuses. And now let's take a different data set and went it through to the same process again. For example, the data extracted from the production. And here we have both partially filled and suspended statuses. And the tools, they can compare both representations and highlight the discrepancies. And this is how it looks like. And if the combined output is visually too much, we can always filter it to see the necessary data. And now it is clear what we need to cover in the test library. So to sum up, the use cases are use single graph as a possible fuel for testing ideas. Second, we can compare two libraries to check for gaps coverage and optimize the libraries. Third, we can compare functional and non-functional testing libraries. And this is to understand if we have the same transitions covered for both testing libraries. And of course, like an example, we can compare test library to production data flow. This is to verify if we lack some scenarios which are meant to be covered, or, for example, if we are testing something that is never happening in production yet. And of course, not only the order status transitions could be checked. Similarly, we can build the diagrams for the instruments, session transitions, market data, etc. So, and basically, how do we build this graph? The workflow is just shown here. So first, we should gather any transactional data from our test systems, including test run captures and application process logs. Then, combine this data into one single database and transform it into the transform this accumulated data into the flat material which our set of tools works with. And based on this accumulated material, we are building process mining model. We can always use the system specification to simplify the graphs, for example, by filtering in or out unacceptable or rare conditions. And in conclusion, the process mining model creates graphical representations for the analysis. And here is the result of the updated test library after the comparison we've performed with the previously displayed production data. And some pictures worth a thousand words. So test coverage is a crucial part of software testing, and this approach allows us to visualize transactional data to obtain a direct representation of test coverage. And this provides us with the result for the analysis and closing the gaps. So please reach out to Exactpro if you would like to learn more about the process mining. And now let's talk about supervised machine learning. And please welcome my fellow colleague, Evgeny Litvinenko.